The goal of issuing students warning cards instead of criminal summonses is straightforward, to keep them from getting a criminal record for relatively minor offenses. Now the city plans to expand the program to all 400 high schools without releasing any data on how a three-year trial went.
This is one more example of the mayor keeping data away from the public. They're not going to record it. You're not going to know about it. The parents aren't going to know about it. So there are not going to be any figures to dispute.
Mayor de Blasio introduced the warning card policy 3 years ago at 5 high school buildings in the Bronx and expanded it to 15 campuses 18 months later. Part of a kinder, gentler approach to school discipline that includes suspending fewer students. The mayor said punitive policies often put teenagers on the wrong path, what he calls the school to prison pipeline. The warning cards are issued by school safety officers who are NYPD employees. New York One first asked for data on the program in early 2017, including how frequently the cards are handed out at each school and for what offenses. The education department said it does not keep track of those numbers. And they told schools in 2017 not to keep track either, even though doing so could alert schools to trouble spots and troubling trends in student misbehavior. The police department tells us they do keep some records on the warning cards, but they've declined to release them to New York One or even tell us what kinds of statistics are kept. Meanwhile, the police and education departments continue to claim crime is falling in the schools, most recently in a release on Friday. The School Safety Officers Union has an interest in portraying schools as not as safe as they should be, but the union president says the warning card policy really does distort what's going on.
The numbers are better because he made crime disappear. He manipulated the books. He cooked the books once again.
There's no limit on how many warning cards a student can receive, and it's left up to them whether to even tell their parents they got one. Lindsay Christ, New York One.